The Raiders are the biggest humanitarians ever. That is sarcasm. The Sands actually just may be the biggest humanitarians ever. That is not sarcasm. Weekly rental people are still being evicted. That sucks, and that's really bad. World Series of Poker may or may not cancel. The Air Force Base declares an emergency, and Walmart nationwide limiting people. You might want to pay attention to that last point. My name is Steve, and I am not leaving Las Vegas. This is a Vegas News Channel. I have a bunch of points to talk about today on the camera, so let's get right to it. By the way, like, share, subscribe the channel if you guys like this kind of stuff. We do these videos pretty much every day, and I can't wait to get back to doing regular Las Vegas videos as well as news. So leave a comment below once you hear about the Raiders. What do you think about the Raiders? What do you think about their donation? I've been trying to find something good about it, so I found one good point, but I found a bunch of stuff that just kind of gets a little bug in my craw that I got to talk to you about. If you guys want to be on the credits of the video, you'll head over to Patreon, and if you guys want to see videos that are not suitable for YouTube because of YouTube's content restrictions, you can also go over there too. So with that being said, somebody in my Las Vegas, not leaving Las Vegas Facebook group yesterday posted up how the Raiders are donating $1 million to the city to help fight the horrible Chinese virus, which, for the record, to update you, has over 1,500 cases in all of Nevada and 42 deaths. Pretty tragic. And I mean, it is $1 million. But something really bugged me about that $1 million. It might have been the $700 million that the city gave the team to build a stadium, of which there's a live construction cam. I'll try to keep it going as long as I can. That comes from KTNV News, so I'll have their ads in it. But I thought I would stream that for you so you could have a place to chat. It might be the $700 million that we gave them. That could be it. It could be the fact that Forbes does valuations of professional sports franchises in North America every year, and they're worth $2.9 billion. $2.9 billion. If the Raiders are worth $2.9 billion, and if we gave them $700 million, I can't really do backflips over the $1 million donation. Now, it is $1 million, and I'm sure there are others. I would love to hear if other celebrities or big pro athletes donated, so make sure you comment below. And if I get some good, strong comments and I can prove that it's true, I might just do a video of who's given back to Las Vegas, and so we can do a list, which would be fun. So, all sarcasm aside, the Sands is doing something amazing. Sheldon Adelson penned an op-ed, that's an opinion editorial, and I think it was in the Washington Post or something like that, about how companies should be responsible to their employees. And they were already paying 10,000 of their workers through the entire closure, from what I can find out. They're now paying all of the third-party restaurant workers' employees' salaries throughout the closure. This brings them to paying 11,900 people through all the closures. Meanwhile, you got Caesars furloughing 90% of all of their employees. You have MGM Resorts laying people off. But you have the Las Vegas Sands Corporation doing something pretty awesome. You know, in my live stream the other day, some user named Wall Street Warlord, who I've never heard of before, sent me a bunch of stickers, and that was really fun. I'm like, wow, nobody has any money. This guy sent me a bunch. So I made sure I paid attention to those comments, of course, because that was really cool. And he asked, do you think Sheldon Adelson is one of the stand-up guys in Vegas? This kind of proves that that's a stand-up guy thing to do. So whatever your opinion on Adelson was, you might want to consider the fact that this is coming directly from the money that the company has. This isn't coming from the state. So these people are going to be paid throughout the closures. That's pretty amazing. The second point is a little less positive than the $1 million Raider donation, which is, we're going to say that's positive, even though it's not enough. I'm sorry. I just got to say it's not enough. This is the Sands was positive. Weekly rental people are being evicted. You might not know what these weekly rental things are, but in Vegas, we have these places. You probably have them where you live too. Budget suites, Siegel suites, basically anything that has the word suites on it. If you're coming here and you can do any better, you should probably avoid them. But they're weekly rentals, meaning that you can go in there with just an identification card and $150 to $200 in your pocket and get a place that has a bed, a little kitchen area, a bathroom, a television, cable internet. Usually they have internet, cable, HBO, and a telephone, a landline. And that's what you do. So These places here are considered like an actual rental place, and you can even use them to go down to the DMV and prove that you live here if you've been there for 8 weeks. Now they're evicting people, so they're not supposed to evict people. The law is that until April 30th, there's a moratorium on all the evictions. Moratorium is a $1 million word to say pause. They're not supposed to be evicting people, but some of these guys are breaking the rules. They're putting piles of big, huge plywood sheathing in front of their parking areas. So people are like, we got to use these when you don't pay your bills. We're going to put that on your door. One guy said that he had his fridge, his television, and all of the sheets ripped out of his place because he was not paying his bills. That's a scumbag thing to do. These people that are doing it should be ashamed of themselves. And I would love to identify who's doing it and throw it right out here on camera, because quite honestly, you're breaking the law to such a point that they could actually received deceptive trade practice infractions, and there's 3 times the fine on those folks. So if you know anybody going through this, send me an email or hit me up on Facebook or on the Patreon and tell me about it so I can do a video exposing these scumbags, because that is a bad thing to do right now. People need a safe place. This is my opinion. I know I try not to do, hey, it's my opinion. I ain't no Andy Rooney. Thumbs up if you remember Andy Rooney, the best part of my Sunday nights for years. But anyways, my opinion is simple. People need a safe place to stay right now. We're supposed to be sheltered in place. Most of these folks don't have the credit or the means, and I know what that feels like in a lot of ways. My wife and I nearly ended up in one of these places at a point in our lives. It's not fun and it's not good. And if you don't have the means to be safe right now, what the heck are you, what are you supposed to do? It's tragic. All right, the World Series of Poker event. We're going to get to Walmart in a minute. They're limiting how many people get into their stores, so I hope you guys stick through for that, because that's a big deal, and it affects the entire country, not just here in Las Vegas, by the way. World Series of Poker, there's a big debate in the social media, Twitter feeds of all these folks saying we should postpone this thing. Everybody's saying we should postpone it. A lot of people saying we should not postpone it. People have already made plans. Not postponed yet. EDC going on in October. World Series of Poker still up in the air for the May 24th event. Whether or not they have it here, if it gets postponed, of course I will tell you about it ASAP. Nellis Air Force Base has declared an emergency state. Nellis Air Force Base, of course, one of the larger Air Force bases in the West Coast. It goes all the way up to the Area 51 area and to Groom Lake. It's just a bunch of land, but it does actually encompass some of the city. If you go in North Las Vegas, you go on Las Vegas Boulevard, the Strip, it goes miles and miles and miles until you're at Nellis. Only essential personnel, medical personnel, can go into the base right now. So if you're one of those families that's living here and you like to go to the commissary and get the deals and all that, you can't go in unless you have a good reason to be there. You have to stay out base. Nobody is really hurt. Nobody is sick. It's just that they want to make sure that it's mitigated, because of course the people that are in the Air Force might have to go to other places. So keep it as clean and as healthy as you possibly can, I suppose. And lastly, we have Wally Land Walmart. This also applies to Target and Costco. Let me give you some math on here to let you know how many people you can put into a store. So Walmart has said, and this is national news, they're going to be limiting the amount of people that can go into a Walmart store at any given time. So they want to basically make it so the greeter at the door now becomes like a bouncer at the nightclub. Now they're going to let you in no matter what. You don't have to dress nice. You don't have to worry about wearing sleeveless shirts. That's how the bouncers work. Bouncers. Well, look at that. I became a Southerner. All right, so we're limiting the amount of folks going into a Walmart store, and it's going to be 5 people per 1,000 square feet. That's terrible. Don't hate me for that. 1,000 people per 1,000 people per 5 square feet. Oh, I should do this video over again, but I'm totally not gonna. It's gonna be 5 people per 1,000 square feet. Now, that's gonna be a nationwide policy. They're making the lanes into a Walmart into a one-way only. By the way, somebody told me that lip readers can't read it when I'm touching my face, and everybody's concerned that I'm touching my face. It's an old habit. It dies hard. I'm sorry. I'll try not to. So that means that if the average Walmart store is 179,000 square feet, because I looked that stat up, and you do the math, that's 179 of those 1,000 square feetages. And if you multiply the math, it's 879 people at a time. Now, I just want to do that math real fast while I talk about this. Why are they actually doing this? Well, I mean, it's obvious. They're trying to make sure that they have everybody being protected. They want to make sure that folks are not within close quarters of each other. And now with the White House and the CDC saying that if you go out of your house, you should probably wear some kind of a bandana or mask or cloth over your face. It's getting serious out here. They want to make sure, the positive of this is they want to make sure that we're getting to the end when it peaks without a whole bunch more people getting sick. Because as it peaks, people are going to get sent, lulled into a false sense of bulletproofness. It's like those kids that went on spring break and now like 40 of them are really sick, but they had this false sense of I can do anything, you can't hurt me. So as we get to the peak, people might think misinformed wise that hey, this is okay, I can go into the store, I can be a normal person again. We can't be normal for a while, folks. I haven't been normal for 39 years, but we can't be normal for a while, so we have to make sure it's safe. So that means that when you show up to the store, they're going to let one person in as one person leaves. So if you're planning a quick trip to the Walmart, the Target, or the Costco, you might want to plan a little bit more time for that. This, of course, applies nationwide, not just here to Las Vegas. My recommendation is simple. Find out the hours of your Walmart, Costco, or Target. Go there in the morning or later before they close, but I don't think it really matters because you're going to get a lineup for the first few days anyways as everybody readjusts to this. That's a bummer, but as long as it keeps people safe, right? So that's it. That's the news for today. What do you guys think? What's your terms on the Raiders? What do you guys like about that? What is your thoughts on the Sands Corporation paying all their employees through everything, plus now all the third-party restaurants, which they don't even own? What do you think about everything? Like, share, subscribe to videos, leave a comment. If you guys want to hit us up on the Facebook group, It's Not Leaving Las Vegas. If you want to be in the credits that'll roll in a few seconds, you can go over to Patreon. If you want to see the videos I can't post up here, you can do that too. I even have a tier where I'm posting up some of the yard work that I'm doing and showing you guys some behind the scenes footage there. I appreciate you guys liking, watching, sharing. Now's the time in the video where I, of course, say 3, 2, 1, and I end the video with a click. So let's get real close to the camera, tell you thank you, and I go 3, 2, 1, and click. Thank you.